Fight by Carol Diggory Shields, pictures by Doreen Gay Castle. Last night, when you were fast asleep, snoring unawares, do you know what happened in the kitchen downstairs? Just about midnight, or a little bit later, the light came on in your refrigerator. The milk peeked out and whispered, "All clear."
"Close the door," yelled the wrench. "I'm dressing in here."
"This place is the pits," all the olives cried. Celery stalked to the door and opened it wide. "Let us have a party," said the salad greens, and slid it to the floor on a bunch of string beans.
"We've been bottled and bagged in, wrapped up tight. We're gonna cut loose and party tonight."
The coffee perked up and the beets started thumping. The bread made toast and the jello was jumping. The almonds acted nutty. The pretzels did a twist. The Swiss cheese yodeled when the chocolates kissed. The tuna fish were singing tunes over by the sink. When the garlic joined in, they yelled,
"You stink!"
The garlic was crushed, felt oh so sad, but his friend Chili Pepper got red hot mad.
"Picking on my buddy? Now that's not right. Are you ready to rumble? 'Cause it's a food fight."
A big box of macaroni elbowed in. The hot dogs started barking and joined the din. The chunky peanut butter jumped into the jam.
"Your chicken," yelled the noodles to some soup in a can.
The rice got steamed and popped the corn.
"Chill out, you guys," the ice cubes warned.
But the punch kept punching and the cream got whipped. The chips threw the crackers in the guacamole dip.
"Food fight, food fight. It's a food fight. We're gonna mix it up and fight all night."
Then high in the cupboard yelled some dishwashing suds, "Hey, knock it off or you'll wake up the spuds." And sure enough, from the vegetable drawer, 10 Idaho potatoes rolled out on the floor. They eyed the mess and then they scowled. "Clean it up now," the potatoes growled. "Put everything away and do it fast, or come tomorrow morning, you'll all be trashed." The fight turned into a cleanup race. All the eggs scrambled to get back in place. The chowder cleaned up, the bananas peeled out, the hamburger helper scurried about. Spaghetti roped up the last pinto beans. The batter pitched in. Soon, the kitchen was clean. The fridge was filled up. Was everyone inside?
"Hey, wait for me," the ketchup cried.
The lights went out, the broom swept away, and everything was ready for a brand new day. But if something downstairs doesn't seem quite right, just ask the cat about what happened last night.